Thomas was at the platform the next day when Percy brought his trucks in from the junction. The trucks were heavy, heavy. He feels so tired, as he puffed, she pulled into the station. Have a drink, said his driver, then you'll feel better. The water column stood at the end of the siding with unsafe buffers. The props underneath the buffers were old. They weren't ever strong enough. They looked heavy, 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 much speak. And ever strangely, Percy was about to have an accident. He moved forward and found himself not stopping. And ever strangely, the buffers didn't stop him either. Oh, I'm Percy. Oh. 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 Oh, good heavens. It is just a crash into some buffers. The buffers were broken and Percy was wheel deep in coal. Was it she making that noise? Of course it was me. You just stand there. Come and help me out. It was time for Thomas to leave. It's everything. He found this ever funny. It was ever strange indeed. Now Percy has learnt his lesson too. He chuckled to himself. But Percy, however, was not ever impressed. He was thinking his friend Thomas must have played one very small trick on him. Maybe, well, of course he was playing one very small trick on him. That night, the two engines made up the quarrel. It didn't cause your accident on purpose, Thomas. Whispered Percy. You do know that, don't you? Of course, replied Thomas. And I'm sorry, Eva's cheeky. Your green paint looks ever splendid again, too. In future, we both need to be more careful of care, said Thomas. Eva, where's that? And let's end this story. Sure, in there.